I'm Kevin. Welcome to the HK Fieldhouse.
Tonight's basketball game will be between the HK Cougars and the Coginchaug Blue Devils.
Both teams have had a solid season so far and are looking to continue with this win.
The starting lineup for the HK Cougars are Annalise Bruder, Caroline Fortuna, Haley Serban, Brinley Anderson, and Tara Murphy.
And for the Coginchaug Blue Devils, we have Audrey Akari, Michaela Wiskel, Naomi Ronaldo, Larissa Cade, and Alana Becker.
Good luck to both teams, and let's go to the game.
Good.
Thank you. You know, Riley, both teams have had solid seasons so far.
Yeah, I've noticed. The girls' teams have been doing really well.
You can start talking right now, and you should probably sit next to me.
So the HK Cougars are, I believe, at 500 in conference play, and the Coginchaug Blue Devils are just above 500 in conference play. So we're looking at a pretty good matchup.
Yeah, I'm excited for the rest of the game.
Great tip by Haley Sermon to Caroline Fortuna.
Both
Caroline puts up
seniors.
A nice shot. Saved by Annalise Bruder. Inside to Tara Murphy. Oh. We have a jump ball, and the Coginchaug Blue Devils will get it. Coginchaug's Audrey Akari brings it up the court and passes to number 22, Naomi Ronaldo.
Too far here.
Coginchaug can't seem to get by the HK Cougars defense. Bounds on the Coginchaug Blue Devils, back to the HK Cougars.
Haley Servant has the ball.
Brinley Anderson will bring it up the court. Inside to Haley Servant. Another inside to Tara Murphy. Annalise puts up the shot. Just missed. Out of bounds on Coginchaug. HK gets the ball back. Rebound by Haley Servant.
So close.
Tara Murphy gets a foul called on her for over the back. Foul called on, I believe it was Brinley Anderson, for a hold. Solid drive inside, but just missed the mark. Back to Haley Servin, who's going to bring it up the court. Attempted an inside pass, but stolen away by Audrey Akari. You know, Riley, the last time these two teams met, it was a very close game. Coginchaug just pulled away at the end, 48-42.
Ooh, that is close. I think I went to that game.
saved by Coginchaug after an attempted pass to Tara Murphy. HK steals it away from Coginchaug.
Caroline Fortuna dribbles up court.
All right, so HK knocked it out of bounds, and Coginchaug will get possession. Audrey Akari dribbles up court. Swing to the top of the swing across the top of the key to Alana Becker. Excuse me, Michaela Wiskel. Coginchaug will inbound the ball.
Audrey Akari has the ball.
All right, so it was tipped out back out of bounds by Tara Murphy, and Coginchaug will retain possession. Nice inbounds pass to Alana Beckert. Coginchaug is still struggling to penetrate HK's defense.
Shot by Larissa Cade, ooh, just missed.
Very close shot. Caroline Fortuna brings it up the court. Pass to Brinley Anderson. Brinley Anderson puts up a three.
Oh.
Just off the mark. Nice shot by Haley Servant. Now HK is on the board. Coginchaug looking to push it up court. Off Brinley Anderson's foot. And that's out of bounds.
Number 22, Naomi Ronaldo, has the ball. Passes it to number 3, Audrey Akari.
Coginchaug continuing to swing. Shot by number 34, Alana Beckert's just off the mark. HK gets the ball back.
Haley Serbit passes it to Brinley, who now dribbles up court.
Inside, attempted pass inside to Tara Murphy, but is stolen away. Number 23, Larissa Cade, attempted a nice little floater, but couldn't get it. Annalise Bruder fouled Alana Beckert, and she will shoot two.
Makes the first. And makes the second.
We're now tied back up at 2-2.
Caroline Fortuna running up court.
Attempted to push it up court. We'll swing it to Brinley Anderson.
Caroline passes back to Brinley.
Swing back to Brinley. Brinley tries to send it inside. Almost stolen away. Pile on the floor. Jump ball, and HK will get the ball back. I don't know, Riley. This looks like it'll be a pretty good game when it comes to defense. Neither team is seeming to budge at all.
It's 2-2, and I mean, it's still in the first quarter, but still, that's a low-scoring game.
Another shot by Haley Serbin just off the mark.
These teams are neck and neck, and it's just the beginning.
Larissa Cade dribbles it up court. Swing back outside to Naomi Ronaldo. Haley Serbin steals the ball and is pushing it up court herself.
Number 3, Audrey Akari, is blocking her.
The HK Cougars will get the ball back. Inbounds to Brinley Anderson. All the way across Caroline Fortuna, who puts up a three, just off the mark. Oh, rebound by Haley and is fouled on the shot. She will shoot two.
She's getting ready. She makes the first. Oh, and just misses the second, right off the backboard.
Rebounded by number 23, Larissa Cade, bringing it up the court herself. Swings it across to Audrey Akari. Drives, puts up a shot, just off the mark. Out of bounds on number 34, Alana Becker. HK gets the ball back. Haley Serban will inbound.
Haley Serban over to Brinley Anderson, now dribbling up court. Passes to Caroline Fortuna.
Swing across the top to Brinley Anderson. Inside to Tara Murphy. Good move, just off the mark. And out of bounds. HK decided to put a press on Coginchaug. Number 23, Larissa Cade, up court.
Number two, Megan O'Brien's going in for Tara Murphy.
Shot put up by number three, Audrey Akari, is on the mark. That's a three. It was a good, great shot by Audrey Akari. Brinley Anderson brings it up court. In the corner to Caroline Fortuna. Back, swinging across the top of the court to Annalise Bruder.
Megan O'Brien passes over to Annalise.
46 seconds left in the quarter. Annalise Bruder in the corner for the shot. No go. Out of bounds, but it was off a Coginchaug player. I didn't see who. So HK will get the ball back. Number 23, Larissa Cade, tips the ball and then gets all the way back court, passing Caroline Fortuna and gets the ball.
Caroline's going up court with it.
Caroline stole it back and is going back up the court. Stolen again by number 14, Michaela Wiskel, but goes out of bounds in the process. HK gets the ball back with 26 seconds left in the quarter. Inbound to Caroline Fortuna. Brinley Anderson has it. Into the middle to Haley Servant. Back outside to Annalise Bruder. Up court to Audrey Akari. Audrey drives. Three seconds left, so Coginchaug will have to inbound it and immediately put it back up. Up. Nope. That's the first quarter. HK is down 3-5. It was a solid first quarter, but I think that this game is really going to come down to defense.
Yeah, neither team can seem to break each other.
I don't know if we will see a change going from zone to man. Both teams are running a solid zone right now, and the opposite team is not able to do anything, really. It'll be interesting to see if they switch it up in the second quarter. Both teams seem to be working on something to try to penetrate the other team. Both teams seem to be trying to work on something to beat the other team's zone.
If someone switches up to man, then they'll have to come up with something else. But it seems like both teams do have a solid defense that the other team's going to have to figure out how to beat if they want to win.
The starting lineups are back in.
Audrey Akari brings it up the court. Swings it to number 23, Larissa Cade. Back to Audrey Akari. Up to number 12, Bridget Turek. Stolen by number 11, Annalise Bruder. Caroline Fortuna brings it up court.
Caroline passes to Brinley. Over to
Tara inside.
And up with Tara and
nice
in.
Shot by Tara Murphy. We are now tied at 5-5. Number 3, Audrey Akari brings it up court. Almost tipped away by Brinley Anderson, but Larissa Cade is able to save it. Number 11, Annalise Bruder is called for the foul. Coginchaug will take it out of bounds. Swing across the top. Back to Audrey Akari. Number 20, double dribble called on number 22, Naomi Ronaldo. Caroline Fortuna brings it up court. Pass to Annalise Bruder.
Over to Tara Murphy.
A lot of pressure in the corner. Caroline Fortuna gets it back at the top of the key. Stolen away by number 22.
Once again, the defense on both sides.
What is called for traveling, so that's no good. Haley Servant will take it out of bounds, and inbounding to Caroline Fortuna, who will then bring it up court.
The defense on both sides is just too tough for either to get through sometimes.
Caroline takes the top. Over to Brinley, almost so. Oh!
Caroline Fortuna gets it back.
Hard pass into the middle and is tipped away. Number 3, Audrey Akari has the ball again and will bring it up court. To the corner to number 22, Naomi Ronaldo, who will immediately pass it back. Nice shot by number 12, Bridget Turek. Over to Brinley Anderson. Over to Annalise. Back to Haley with the corner shot. Just off the mark. Rebounded by Tara Murphy, who puts it up. No good. Number 3, Audrey Akari will get it back. Pushing it up court.
Throws it up and no, just missed.
Haley Servant gets it back. Bring it up court herself. Caroline back to Annalise. Or back to Caroline. Brinley looks for the shot, doesn't get it. Steps out of bounds, and Coginchaug will get the ball back. I think one of the main stories of this game, Riley, is definitely the fact that HK only has two seniors, and the Coginchaug Blue Devils have multiple seniors on the court.
Yeah, Caroline and Haley both are playing really well today.
Number 3, Audrey Akari will bring it up the court. Coginchaug still struggling to get it past HK's defense. It's a 3, no good. Caroline gets the rebound, brings it up court. Corner pass into Tara Murphy, and that's another 2 points for Tara Murphy. She's definitely going to have a great game if she keeps this up.
Bridget Turek going up court.
That's you,
baseline. Oh, nice pass. Nice pass to number 12, Bridget Sharek, who will score.
Caroline Fortuna going up court.
Haley gets underneath, puts it up, no good. And it will go back to white ball.
Timeout called by HK.
Although HK only has two seniors, Haley Serban is a forward that will beat you by dribbling, which is not something a forward usually does. And Caroline's a solid guard all around.
I agree. I can't tell what it is this period, but definitely the intensity is way up on both teams.
Still a low-scoring game.
All comes back to that defense. Good turnout in the Cougar Den. You know, us Cougars come to support our other Cougars.
Lots of school spirit at HK. All right, so HK will get the ball back. Looks like Caroline Fortuna will inbound the ball. Inbound it to Tara Murphy, who will put it up. That's another 2 points for Tara Murphy. She's only a freshman, you gotta remember that.
It's 9-9 and 4 minutes on the clock.
Stolen away by Caroline Fortuna. And it will go out of bounds back to Coginchaug.
Over to number 12, Bridget Turek.
Shot put up, no good. Out of bounds on Coginchaug, and it will be HK ball. Inbounded to Caroline Fortuna, who will bring it up the court. Over to Haley Serban, dribbles in.
That's a block called on number 34, Alana Beckert. Caroline Fortuna will inbound. Over to Haley Servant. Puts up a three.
And in. And
great shot by Haley Servant.
It's now 12-9 for HK.
Number 12 will bring it up the court, Bridget Turek.
Coginchaug swinging the ball into the middle. Back out. Puts up a three.
Just missed by Losha Cade.
Number 23, Larissa Cade, was fouled on a three-pointer, so she will shoot three free throws. Just off the mark on the first and makes the second. Missed on the third, rebounded by Megan O'Brien. Brinley Anderson takes up the court. Pass over to Caroline Fortuna. Inside to Brinley. It was a wide open shot and just off the mark.
Rebounded by Megan O'Brien.
Haley Servant puts up another shot.
And in.
Great shot by Haley Servant for 2 points.
It's now 14-10 HK.
Number 12, Bridget Turek brings it up court. Inside to number 14, Michaela Wiskel. Number 3, Audrey Akari. Inside to 14, Wiskel again. Rips the ball away, but it is a jump ball. HK will get the ball back.
two subs going in for Coginchaug. Number 21, Amy Akari. And
Caroline Fortuna goes up court. Passes over to Haley Serban. Haley looks to Brinley. Oh, and a nice
block. Away by Audrey Akari. Gets it just under the basket. Good move.
And a nice shot by Audrey Akari.
Still a very close game, 14-12. Caroline brings it up court. Decides not to drive. Over to Brinley, who will shoot. Almost.
Rebounded by Megan O'Brien.
Great
over
rebound.
To Caroline Fortuna. Caroline.
Nice shot by Caroline.
It. Nice Caroline. 2 minutes left on the clock.
Number 23, Larissa Cade will bring it up court.
Shoots and
nice shot by Audrey Akari. That's for 3 points. Up to Brinley. The speed of the game definitely picked up in the last couple minutes.
Over to Haley. I told you, Kevin, that intensity level keeps increasing as the game goes on.
Saved by Coginchaug, who will number 34, Alana Becker, who will pass it over to number 3, Audrey Akari, who will then pass it again to number 23, Larissa Cade. Inside to number 22, Naomi Ronaldo. Stolen away by Tara Murphy. Over
Caroline
to Caroline.
Fortuna.
Caroline passes
it to Haley
Serban. Nice
shot.
Little hook. Just missed. Number 22, Naomi Ronaldo gets the rebound and passes over to number 23, Larissa Cade. Brings it up court.
Those are some two big names this
over
game.
To number 21, Amy Akari. Again, over to number 21, Amy Akari. Inside number 22, Naomi Ronaldo.
23 shoots and makes
nice
it.
Nice shot by number 23, Larissa Cade. Keeping this game nice and tight. Inside to Tara Murphy, outside to Caroline Fortuna, over to Brinley Anderson. Brinley Anderson kicks it out to Haley Serban, who will shoot just off the mark, rebounded by Megan O'Brien.
Megan O'Brien.
Almost had it.
21 seconds left on the clock at 17-17. Number 2, Megan O'Brien. She makes
Megan
it first.
Makes it first. Free throws are one of the most underrated part of the games, but they are extremely important, especially in close games like this. You can't afford to miss any. Megan O'Brien will shoot the second, just off the mark, rebounded by Coginchaug. Number 11, Annalise Bruder will go back in the game for number 2, Megan O'Brien. Haley will inbound the ball.
Brinley Anderson looks for someone to pass to, goes to Haley Serban. Gets called for traveling.
HK decides to do a man-to-man press, it looks like. Haley Serban called for a block. HK now has 6 fouls, so Coginchaug will shoot 1 of 1. If she makes the first, she has a second shot. If she misses the first, then it's free for rebounding. So, nice shot by number 3, Audrey Akari. She will get a second free throw. Just missed the second one. Ooh. Haley attempts to save ball and goes out of bounds on number 22, Naomi Ronaldo. Coginchaug will get the ball back.
That was crazy.
Number three, Audrey Akari drives, puts one up and misses. Tara Murphy called for the foul.
Tara Murphy will come out of the game, and Samantha Mohammed will go in for her. Audrey Carey's back on the line.
And she makes
solid
a shot.
Free throw shooter. We'll shoot a second.
And she makes
the
it.
Second. Haley Servin inbounds the ball to Brinley Anderson. Brinley Anderson brings it up court, attempts to drive, passes out to Caroline Fortuna, puts one up, just misses.
And let's put it over to Haley Servin.
The score is 18-20, Coginchaug. I honestly think that this game is still coming down to defense.
Could it get any closer, Kevin? A little bit. It could get a little closer.
It could get a little closer. It could be tied.
These teams are neck and neck.
So far, I think that the main components to both teams, for HK, definitely Tara Murphy inside, and also Haley Serbent. Caroline Fortuna also with nice passing.
Both and seniors then, are doing great tonight.
And then for Coginchaug, Audrey Akari has had a solid game, and Michaela Wiskel has also had a pretty good game.
The names Larissa Cade and Audrey Akari keep popping up. Those are some two big players for Coginchaug. Great performance, as always, by the HK cheerleaders.
Now we'll go over to a baton twirling routine by HK's own Zoe Corey. Zoe twirls for all the main sports events each season, so she does the girls and boys basketball games, and she also does the football games in the fall.
She's a big attraction for everyone in the Cougar Den.
Thank you.
as always, by Zoe Corey. Zoe's a senior this year and plans on doing baton twirling in college.
She never seems to disappoint at these type of events. Yeah,
and she always comes up with her own routines. I think that's very cool. Kevin, what do you expect coming into this next quarter?
I think that both teams are definitely going to have to change up their defense, change up their offense if they want to beat the other team's defense. Both teams have had solid zones in the first half, and if they keep that up, then they definitely...
So, Kev, what are you saying about their offense?
So, I think that definitely they're going to have to come up with some type of play to beat the other team's defense. And if they don't, then it's probably going to end up being a very low-scoring game as it is right now.
If you were one of the coaches right now, what would you be telling the team?
Well, I'd definitely be telling them to drive a little bit more. I think that if both teams try to penetrate the other team's defense a little bit more, then there's probably going to be a little bit more scoring and definitely more shot attempts, which the more times you shoot, the more baskets you're going to make. I think that both coaches should definitely tell their players that they are playing solid in the first half, but I think both teams need to distribute the ball a little bit more to each other and just pass and definitely try to put up more shots. What about you, Riley? What would you say as a coach?
If I was their coach, I just tell them, like you said, it's right now both teams' defense is, really holding strong. So if the defense is working, you got to work on the offense.
I definitely like to see a little more driving by both teams.
A little bit in that second quarter.
Yeah, as things picked up intensity-wise, there was definitely a little bit more driving. But
quarter, there wasn't a lot.
Both teams are settling for outside shots, which don't always work. HK started to find their groove in Tara Murphy and started to give her the ball a little bit more, and it definitely paid off. Coginchaug has been very strong on their free throws, and that's definitely helping them to stay in the game and right now lead. So I'd like to see them continue with their free throw success and also continue to make shots.
Coginchaug's rebounds have been pretty successful so far.
That's also true. Both teams have had very solid rebounding in the first half. If they continue that, then everything else will kind of follow through.
Yeah.
Not a lot of subbing by both teams. I think the starting five for both teams are definitely tired, but both teams seem very well conditioned to play an entire game. So,
Coginchaug and HK have both been, pretty consistent with their starting lineup. You've seen a little more Megan O'Brien and Tara Murphy switching out, and Sam Muhammad also got in there for a little bit.
I think both teams have solid, deep rosters that they can afford to sub and really put anyone in the game and have confidence that they will do good things on the court. So hopefully they can continue that and really use the bench to their advantage.
I have high expectations for this half on both teams, and let's see what happens.
It'll definitely be interesting to see what both teams change, if one team will switch to man instead of zone, or if they'll stick with zone. Although if they decide to stick with zone, I think that would definitely pay off. But if one team did come up with something during halftime to beat the other team's zone, then they could be in trouble. So I'd like to see both teams use a little bit of man in the second half. Thank you. All right, Riley, here we go. The second half is getting underway. All right, so Coginchaug will get the ball to start the half. Number 22,
Naomi Rinaldo. Over to Larissa Cade.
That's Audrey Acarli, right? Audrey Acarli. Okay. Turnover, and Haley Servant will get the ball, inbounding to Caroline Fortuna.
Who's now pushing it up court.
Over to Brinley Anderson, swings it across the top. Annalise Bruder puts up just off the mark. White will get the ball back. Coginchaug touched it, going out of bounds, so White will get the ball back. Annalise Bruder will inbound the ball.
She passes it over to Caroline Fortuna.
Inside to Tara Murphy, back out to Haley Servant with the shot, just off the mark. Over to number 23,
Larissa Cade.
Across the top to Audrey Acarli.
Audrey's looking for somewhere to go. Larissa Cade has it back.
Over to Audrey Acarli into the corner to number 34. Alana Becker stolen away.
By Caroline Fortuna.
Pushes it up court.
Caroline
over
looks
to Brinley Anderson. Almost stolen away by number 3, Audrey Acarli. Caroline has it.
Over to Annalise Bruder.
Into the middle.
Tara Murphy fumbles with the ball, but Caroline
nice
gets it back.
Shot by Caroline Fortuna, just off the mark. Haley will rebound and out of bounds. Excuse me, that's a foul. That's a foul on number 22, Naomi Rinaldo. Number 12, Bridget Turex. Subs into the game for number 22, Naomi Rinaldo. HK's own Annalise Bruder inbounds the ball, sends it up to top to Tara Murphy, decides to drive. Caroline gets in the corner, back inside to Tara Murphy. Over to Caroline
shoots,
who shoots a three
just off the mark.
Number 14, Michaela Wiskel rebounds the ball and passes it over to Audrey Acarli, who will bring it up court. Over to 23, Larissa Cade. Into the corner to number 34, Alana Becker. Back to number 12, Bridget Turek. Number 23,
Larissa Cade
now has the ball. Passes it over to number 12, Bridget Turek. Into the middle, nice drive. And a lay-in by number
14, Michaela Whiskey.
That was a good drive. That's just what I was talking about at the half. Over to Brinley Anderson, who decides not to take the shot. Over to Annalise
Bruder,
Will.
Who does. Off the mark.
Off the mark. Number 23 gets the ball, pushes it up court.
Larissa Cade,
good move, but it's knocked away by number 23, Caroline Fortuna. Caroline will commit a foul. And number 23, Larissa Cade will shoot two.
Cade's just off the mark with her first shot.
Shoots her second. Nice shot by Larissa Cade. Inbounded to Caroline Fortuna, who brings it up the court. HK decides to set something up. Brinley Anderson gets the ball. Pass into the middle is knocked away. Number 14, Michaela Whistle comes up with
Larissa
it.
Larissa Cade pushes it up court. And she makes it.
That was a great drive.
Caroline Fortuna looks where to go.
Brinley Anderson has the ball at the top. Number 23.
Larissa Cade will turn over.
Number 23, Larissa Cade will inbound the ball. Over to number 3. Coginchaug was being pressured, so no one's back for HK.
just off the mark on her layup. Saved by number 23, Larissa Cade. Number 12 with the ball at the top, Bridget Turek. Foul on HK. Foul by HK, excuse me. Number 34, Brinley Anderson with, or excuse me, 44, Tara Murphy with the hold. Up to the top to Larissa Cade, over to the corner. That's blocked by number 23, Caroline Fortuna. Haley Sturman comes up with the ball and pushes it up court. Over to Tara Murphy with the layup.
And she
nice shot
it.
By Tara Murphy.
On the mark.
HK decides to put a little bit of pressure on Coginchaug.
Akari has the ball.
Looks like she's going to shoot, but decides not to. Number 14.
And makes it.
14,
right,
Michaela Wisco with a nice banked two.
Caroline Fortuna pushes it up court.
Pass over to Annalise Bruder. Back to Caroline. Over to Brinley Anderson, who will shoot the three. Just off the mark. Number 23,
Larissa Cade
with a nice rebound. Over to number 12. It's a great pass, but decides to shoot a little too late. Haley Sturban will inbound the ball.
Haley over to Caroline, the two seniors on HK's team.
Annalise Bruder gets the ball. It's being double-teamed. Over to Brinley.
Brinley over to Annalise.
Annalise Bruder with a nice drive down the baseline.
Rebounded by Haley.
Haley Sturban.
There are 3 minutes and 48 seconds left on the clock, and it's 20 to 27 for Coginchaug.
Blue 23, Larissa Cade's called for the foul. Annalise Bruder inbounds the ball to Caroline Fortuna, who immediately puts up a shot just off.
Ooh. Akari pushes it up court.
Decides not to drive, pulls it back out. Coginchaug decides that they're going to set something up. Number 12, Bridget Turek has the ball. Good move. Can't get it to go. Caroline Fortuna has it. Pushes it over to Haley Sturban, who will put up a three. Misses. Rebounded by number 34, Alana Becker. Passes it over to number 12, Bridget Turek, who has it at the top. Stolen away by Caroline Fortuna, who will push it up court. Over to Brinley Anderson, brings it inside to Haley Sturban. Over to Tara Murphy, drives in, pulls up. Nice
Tara
jump shot by Tara
it.
Murphy.
HK is 22.
Timeout, Coginchaug.
Kevin, I've definitely seen a lot more risks being taken this period already. You know, more shots on both sides.
There's a lot more driving, a lot more attacking into the lane. Both teams seem to be getting more comfortable with driving, and it's definitely showing. A lot more points being scored. Definitely a lot more offense. But still, both defenses are extremely strong at the moment. Neither one will seem to budge. Still a very low-scoring game. This timeout definitely seemed to be called, definitely to slow down a little bit of momentum. Both teams are starting to get pretty excited and starting moving really fast, and I think Coach definitely had on his mind to call the timeout, definitely to slow things down and get people back under control.
You're right, both teams were getting a little ahead of themselves.
Number 12, Bridget Turek, will inbound the ball. Over to number 14. Michaela Wiskel, back to number 12, Bridget Turek. 23, Larissa Cade will drive, puts up a layup, just missed, but is fouled on her shot attempt.
She will shoot two.
Arissa Cade puts it up. Right on the mark for her first one. Right on the mark for a second. Perfect
Haley's
swoosh.
Servant decides to put it, get the ball in pretty fast. Caroline brings it up. Knocked away by number 20.
Ashley Halligan.
23, Larissa Cade at the top. Nice screen by number 34, Alana Becker. Over to number 14, Michaela Wiskel. Into the corner, just off the mark. Number 14 rebounds and puts it up just off the mark again.
Megan O'Brien has the rebound. Goes to Brinley Anderson.
Brinley Anderson will bring it up. Coginchaug showing a little bit of pressure. Megan O'Brien at the top, over to Brinley Anderson. Swings again to Caroline, who's open for the three.
And
she makes it. Nice three by Caroline Fortuna. Larissa Cade brings it up. Over to number 20, Ashley Halligan. Number 34, Alana Becker. Over to number 14, Michaela Wiskel. Back to number 12, Bridget Turek, who will drive. Kicks it out to number 20, Ashley Halligan.
Perfect shot.
Nice shot by Ashley Halligan.
Brinley Anderson pushes it up court. Over to Caroline Fortuna.
Coginchaug definitely turned on the shooting in the second half, and it's showing.
Defense is still really strong on both sides.
Number 23, Larissa Cade, has the ball and will bring it up court. Number 12, Bridget Trek drives. Blocked by number
14,
Sam Muhammad.
Caroline Fortuna has the ball. Passes over to H.K. Serban.
Haley Serban drives, puts it up, just misses.
Brinley
Anderson
has the rebound.
Rebounds. Can't get it up. That's a foul on number 20, Ashley Halligan. Brinley Anderson will shoot two. Nice critical first free throw from Brinley Anderson. Brinley Anderson will shoot her second. Just off the mark, rebounded by number 3, Audrey Akari.
Akari pushes it up court.
Over to number 20, Ashley Halligan. Number 20 will shoot.
And
nice shot by Ashley Halligan. Caroline Fortuna pushed it up. That's the end of the third quarter. Coginchaug pulled away a little bit. It's now 34-26, Coginchaug.
After that timeout called by Coginchaug, there was definitely a slowdown in the momentum and the speed of the game.
Definitely. HK definitely trying to pick up the defense a little bit, and Coginchaug still trying to keep their foot on the gas pedal and continue to push the ball up the court and drive and shoot and continue to score. Energy level definitely picking up from the first half.
Period. This is a low-scoring game, Kevin.
Definitely. I think both teams are, even though Coginchaug made a run at the end, I think both teams are still playing extremely solid defense.
26-34 for Coginchaug.
Here we go in the fourth quarter.
What do you expect to see this last quarter?
HK definitely pushing the offense a little bit. Coginchaug definitely is going to want to keep their defense strong if they want to come away with the win. I think that both teams definitely need to pick up the intensity and continue to score if they want to win.
I agree. If they want to win, they really got to work on their offense.
Brinley Anderson putting pressure on the inbounder. Ashley Halligan drives, immediately shoots, off the mark.
Rebounded by Haley Servant.
Not afraid to push it up the court herself, and she does.
Goes over to Caroline Fortuna.
Thrown out of bounds, and it will be Coginchaug ball.
Number 12, Bridget Turek, is subbing in for number 20, Ashley Halligan.
And Aubrey Akari
HK decides
has the ball.
To put on a full court press. Number 34 passes to number 14, Michaela Wiskel, almost stolen away. Number 3 puts up a shot.
And perfect.
It's a nice three, but nice three by number 3, Audrey Akari. Brinley Anderson pushes it up the court. Into Tara Murphy. Outside to Caroline Fortuna. Over Brinley Anderson. Over again to Annalise Bruder. Pressured. Into Haley Servant, who rips the ball away, passes out to Caroline Fortuna, who puts up a three just off the mark. Saved by Annalise Bruder, but saved to Coginchaug. Number 12, Bridget Turek has the ball. We pass it over to number 3, Audrey Akari, who will bring it up court. Number 23, Larissa Cade has the ball. Passes over to number 12, Bridget Turek. Over to Michaela Wiskel. Underneath number 23, puts up a shot. No, the shot will not count. Jump ball. HK gets the ball back. Here comes Caroline Fortuna. Over to Annalise Bruder. Back over to Brinley Anderson. Over to Annalise Bruder again.
Back
to Brinley.
Brinley,
over to Caroline. Caroline puts up the shot.
And
nice
right
shot by
mark.
Caroline Fortuna. That is a three.
That means a lot this late in the game.
Over to number 12, Bridget Turek, who will drive, feeds it inside to number 14, Michaela Wiskel. Back out to number 12, Bridget Turek. Swings it again. Drives, puts up the shot.
Rebounded by Annalise Bruder. Brinley
Anderson
really pushes it up court.
Over to Caroline, excuse me. Puts up another three, misses.
Tara
rebounded by Tara
in.
Murphy,
it
puts
in.
It up. Great shot by Tara
that
Murphy.
That ball took its time.
Yeah.
Left on the clock, and it's 31-37 Coginchaug.
Number 34, Alana Beckert. Number 34, Alana Beckert is fouled on the shot. Will shoot two. Timeout called by the Cougars. Thank you. All right, so now number 34, Alana Beckert, will shoot her two free throws.
Makes the first.
Once again, free throws at the end of the game are extremely critical. They can be the make or break in the game.
And makes the second. Haley Serbent takes the ball over to Caroline Fortuna.
Caroline will bring it up court. Passes over to Annalise Bruder. A nice drive inside.
Tara Murphy gets the ball.
Murphy. Back up top to Brindley. Brindley drives out to Annalise, who will shoot.
It goes
off
up,
the mark.
But misses now.
Rebounded by number 23.
Larissa Cade has the ball. Pushing it up court.
Decides to bring it up court herself. Over to number 3, Audrey Akari. Continually swinging it. Back over to number 23, Larissa Cade. Picks up her dribble. Stolen by Haley Serbin, who will bring it up and is fouled on her shot. Attempts to lay it in herself and is fouled, so she will shoot two.
Scores 31-39 for Coginchaug. 4 minutes and 28 seconds left. These two shots really count for Haley and the team. Makes the first.
Nice shot by Haley Serbent. Free throws are definitely going to keep the Cougars in the game.
And just off the mark for her second.
Rebounded by number 34. That was Alana Beckert. Jump ball, and HK will get the ball back. Excuse me, Coginchaug will get the ball back. Over 34, Alana Beckert.
Number 3, Audrey Akari puts it in.
Caroline Fortuna brings it up the court. Over to Brindley Anderson, puts up a deep three.
And
nice
right
shot
in.
By Brindley Anderson.
Right on the mark, perfect swoosh and
definitely
a three.
Important. Definitely important to the game. Haley steals it back. Is fouled. Great sequence of events for the Cougars. Annalise Bruder will pass the ball in. Inbounded to Caroline Fortuna, brings it up to the top. Over to Brindley. Inside to Tara Murphy. Underneath again to Annalise. Puts it up, misses. Almost saved by Coginchaug, but is sent out of bounds, and HK will get the ball back. Number 22, Naomi Rinaldo, will sub in for number 12, Bridget Turek. Great shot by the Cougars. Devils will call another timeout. HK making a nice push at the end of the game.
3 minutes and 34 seconds left. 37-41 for Coginchaug. Kevin, why do you think Coginchaug called that timeout?
Definitely to slow down the Cougars. The Cougars are making a great run, great sequence of events for them, and they really picked it up and are making very clutch shots and are continuing to really just penetrate the Coginchaug's defense and are continuing to score and just really turn this game around. Cougars are making a nice run, and let's see if they can pull it out. Minutes left is definitely a lot of time for the Cougars. They definitely have a good chance of tying this thing up. But it all comes down to if Coginchaug's defense can stop them, and they've been strong all game, so we'll have to see if they can stop them late in the
game. And they've been pretty consistent with their defense.
They have been very consistent.
HK really just has to push.
HK putting a lot of pressure on the Blue Devils. HK getting the ball back. Haley Sermon will inbound. Into Caroline Fortuna. HK definitely trying to pick up the intensity. Over to Annalise Bruder. Coginchaug is responding and putting a lot of pressure on the Cougars. Over to Caroline. Inside to Haley. Out to Annalise. Over to Caroline. Over to Brindley. Puts one dribble. Inside to Tara. Stolen away by Coginchaug. HK is getting called for the push. Brindley Anderson called on the foul. Looks like HK is putting man-to-man pressure on Coginchaug.
Number 23 puts it up and makes
nice
it.
Nice layup by number
goes
23,
right,
Larissa Cade. Caroline Fortuna over to Annalise. Back to Caroline, stolen away. Almost stolen away. Caroline regains control. Over to Brindley, puts up a three. Just off. Annalise with a nice rebound. He's called for traveling. Number 22, Naomi Rinaldo will inbound. Timeout called by the Cougars, I believe.
What would you be telling the Cougars?
I don't really know. I think that was definitely a hard sequence of events for them that time. Coginchaug really picking up the intensity. And
that other timeout really slowed them down.
Yeah.
That took away their own momentum and gave it right to Coginchaug.
So we get this game back underway with 2 minutes and 33 seconds left. HK with 37 points and Coginchaug with 43.
Coginchaug's just got to be consistent for this win.
Coginchaug will inbound the ball. Number 23, Larissa Cade will inbound. Looks like HK is deciding not
to
put any pressure
on
them.
Audrey Akari. HK is really focusing on their defense right now.
Over number 3, Audrey Akari. Decides to drive herself. Kicks it over to number 34, Alana Becker. Back to number 3. Almost stolen away by Annalise Bruder. Number 14, Michaela Wisco with the ball. Number 23,
Larissa
brings
Cade
it herself,
puts it up.
Almost.
Megan O'Brien going in for Annalise Bruder.
Haley Servin will inbound the ball to Caroline Fortuna. Critical mistake for the Cougars. Haley Servant lets the ball go off her own feet. HK once again showing that man-to-man press. Into number 23,
Larissa
Cade.
Going up court.
Stepped out of bounds. HK will get the ball back with a minute 40 left. This is definitely a critical possession for the Cougars, inbounded to Caroline Fortuna.
Caroline over to Haley Serbent right in the middle.
Over to Tara. He gives it back to Haley, attempts to give it back to Haley, but it's stolen away. Stolen away by Audrey Akari, who will bring it up herself. Almost loses control of the ball. Nice behind the back dribbling. Audrey Akari really showing off her dribbling skills. Attempting to run out the clock. Over to number 14, Michaela Wiskel. Coginchaug is definitely just trying to run out the clock here. Coginchaug will call a timeout. HK definitely needs to get the ball back if they want another two chances to score, because that's the least they would need.
There's a minute left, which is plenty of time for both teams.
Inbounded to number 14, Michaela Wiskel. Immediately fouled by Tara Murphy. Excuse me, Tara Murphy. Number 22, Naomi Ronaldo will inbound the ball. HK is trying to foul Coginchaug. Excuse me, that's HK's seventh foul. So number 14, Michaela Wiskel, will shoot one-on-one. Makes her first.
Makes it. Just off the mark for a second.
Brinley Anderson will bring it up court. Only about a minute left in the game. Fouled by number 22, Naomi Ronaldo. Brinley will shoot one of one as well.
Brinley Anderson just off the mark with her foul shot.
It was definitely a critical foul shot. Hopefully, HK will be able to pull something out.
Sam Muhammad going in for Tara Murphy.
Off the mark on her first. Haley Serbin gets the rebounds, pushing it up court herself. Out to Brinley. Brinley puts one up and misses. Rebounded by Coginchaug. Over to number three, Audrey Akari. HK once again just trying to foul to stop the clock. But Coginchaug, HK does have eight fouls, so Coginchaug is still in that one-on-one. Number three, Audrey Akari will shoot. Makes her first, so she will shoot a second. Yeah.
makes her second. Great shot by Audrey Akari. Caroline Fortuna brings up the court. Almost by Haley Servant.
23 seconds left on the clock.
Everyone's on the floor fighting for the ball.
Number 12 for Coginchaug going in.
Number 12 is Bridget Turek.
Number 23, Larissa Cade inbounding the ball. Into number 12, Bridget Turek. Back to number 23. Bringing it up court herself is fouled. HK now has 10 fouls, so Coginchaug will shoot two no matter what. These free throws could definitely be the nail in the coffin for HK.
Just off the mark for Alyssa Cade. 16 seconds on the clock.
Makes her second. Megan O'Brien will inbound to Brinley Anderson. Brinley Anderson pushes it up the court really fast. Not a lot of time on the clock. Haley will drive and shoot just off the mark. Rebounded by Coginchaug. Nice shot by Caroline Fortuna. And that is the game. Both teams played exceptionally well. Tough loss for HK and a great win for Coginchaug.
With HK TV, I'm Riley Fitzgibbons.
And I'm Kevin Geis.
And we'll see you next time.